Hi guys, I'm Amy. Welcome back to my channel. Today I am going to be sharing with you all my TBR for the Autumn Readathon. The Autumn Readathon is hosted by Mercedes at Mercy's Bookish Musings. This is the second year that she will be doing this readathon, and I participated last year and really, really enjoyed it. And I'm also really excited about the fact that she decided to keep the same prompts from last year to carry over to this year. I like that idea a lot because I like predictability and I like tradition, and I'm excited to see what books I read throughout the years for the same prompt. So if you guys are interested in participating in this readathon, it will be taking place from October 20th through the 26th, and I will leave her announcement video and all that information down below in the info bar for you guys if you want to check more out. But if you're interested to see the books I'm hoping to get to throughout the week, then go ahead and keep on watching. So there are four prompts this year carried over from last year, like I said, and two bonus prompts, which I'm going to go ahead and point out really quick right now, which are to read a short story collection and also to read a book with a young female protagonist. And I'm pretty sure that I managed to incorporate those two within the four main prompts. So I have four books to share with you guys. And the first prompt, which incorporates the read a short story collection, is to read a gothic slash spooky book. And for that, I selected Her Body and Other Parties by Carmen Maria Machado. And from all accounts that I have heard, this book is very disturbing and creepy because it really delves into femininity and what it means to be a woman and the rules and expectations that society has placed on us as women. And I've just, like, it talks about, you know, like, ghosts and girls with bells for eyes, so it sounds very creepy and atmospheric, and I do love a really good short story collection, and I've been meaning to read this one for a while now. So I'm really, really excited for this excuse to read it, and this is also a book I can kind of sprinkle throughout the week. I don't usually read multiple books at a time, but if I do have a short story collection, sometimes I will drag it out farther and read books in between the short stories. So hoping to get to this one, and I mean, that cover is just gorgeous, isn't it, guys? It's beautiful. So beautiful. Prompt number two is to read a nonfiction book that feels autumnal, and Mercedes is qualifying that as nature writing or cold location travel writing slash memoir. And for that, I have selected Peter Wolbian's, is that how you say his name? Yes. The Hidden Life of Trees, which is what they feel and how they communicate discoveries from a secret world. And I've heard really, really amazing things about this book, and it's not very big, which is also why I selected it for the readathon. And I believe it's translated from the German, and the translation was done by Jane Billinghurst. And what is a better time to read about trees than in the fall when they're so beautiful and changing? I don't know a ton more about this book, but when I saw it at my library sale, I had to pick it up because it was so inexpensive, and it is a book that was on my radar. And again, like, the perfect season to read about trees. And I'm also excited that it's translated because I don't think I've read any translated nonfiction before. And that's a new experience that I'm looking forward to as well. Prompt number three is to read a novel set in a cold setting. And this is a book that I have been meaning to read for so long now. And I am slightly ashamed by the fact that I've waited so long to read it. But I think it's partially because this author has written one of my favorite books of all time. And so it's like that nervous, hopeful feeling that if you want to love it, but what if you don't? And it's kind of a scary thing as a reader. Am I right, guys? And that is A Constellation of Vital Phenomenon by Anthony Mara. And this is a story about a young girl who sees her father murdered, I believe. Oh, abducted, in the middle of the Russian woods. And then her neighbor rescues her when he finds her, and then he takes her to a woman named Sonia's place. And I believe this book only takes place over the course of like 5 days, but it's in Russia and it's snowy and it's Anthony Mara. And I adored The Tsar of Love and Techno. If you've been around my channel for any period of time, then you know how much I loved that book and Mara's prose, and I'm so excited to get to this book. This is the biggest book I picked for the week, so I'm really hopeful that if I start with this and like read it real quick, I'll be able to bust out the other three picks that I have. But like I said, like, a nervous excited about this book because I did love his short story collection so much. And like I said, this book fills in, did I say, the bonus prompt of a young female protagonist, because the little girl in it is only 8 years old. So I just, so this ticks so many boxes. Anthony Mara, atmospheric. I love books that take place over only a few days. Young female protagonist. I do love adult books from the point of view of young children, although I think there are two different point of views. Like I said, the woman named Sonia. I don't know much else about it, but I don't need to because it just, I hope it's good. I so hope it's good. If you've read it, let me know. And be honest, you gotta be honest. And prompt number four is to read a historical fiction novel. And for this, I have picked a graphic novel, which I think is largely based on true stories, but I do believe that it's classified as a novel and as fiction. And this graphic novel is a very, very popular, big deal, winner of the Pulitzer Prize. Can you guys guess what it is? Mouse by Art Spiegelman. This is, of course, the story about the Nazis being portrayed in the cartoon as cats and the Jews as mice. And this is a arts attempt to work through what happened to, I believe, his father during World War II. I really haven't heard anyone recently talk about this book, but I know that it's very well loved and very poignant and emotional and rich. And I also thought it would be a really, really great pick for a readathon because a graphic novel is much easier and quicker to get through. This is the 2-volume edition, and I do hope to read both of them, but it is a graphic novel that I've had on my shelves for a while now and have been meaning to get to. And again, like, the perfect excuse. This is what I love about readathons. They give you an excuse to pick specific books that you probably wouldn't have picked up right now, but you're going to because it fits the prompt, and I love that about it. So, going to give this a shot. Again, if you guys have read this, let me know what your thoughts were. I do tend to really enjoy graphic novels. They're just a good way to change pace of how you typically read, and the artwork looks gorgeous. And I did technically study this a little bit in a art class that I took in college, so I'm excited to actually sit down and read the whole narrative. Alrighty guys, there you have it. There is my TBR for the autumn readathon. Probably one of my favorite readathons because it's autumnal and it's in the autumn and it's cozy and it involves warm tea and blankets and the fall. Some of my favorite things. But if you guys are planning on participating, please let me know what your TBR is, or if you have a TBR, let me know and I will check it out because I love to know what other people are reading or planning on reading. And if you guys like this video, please like it. And if you loved it, please subscribe, and we'll see you in my next video. Happy reading. There shouldn't have been as much of a struggle as